stops right there.
You don't see the sound waves, but they're in the air everywhere. You see, even though we can't see it, it's there.
Sound waves are in the air right now. The thing about it is we don't have a device to catch the frequency. If you had a device to catch the frequency, amen, you can hear folks talking, and they miles and miles away. Because the sound waves are in the air. They're in the air. They're in the air. What did God say in His Word? What He said in His Word is still in the air. You need to tune in to what God says. And that's what we're trying to get you to do, to tune in. I can't get no help in here. Tune in, tune in. His Word is still true. Now, what are the of the might of God? Power of God's might is the Holy Spirit. And either you have it or you don't. How does it come? It comes by believing. Romans 10, 9 and 10 lets us know that if we believe, confess in our mouth the Lord Jesus Christ, and believe in our heart that God has raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. Now, it's not just a matter of you believing, but you have to act on what you believe. You have to act on what the Word of God says about you. You have to act, put it in motion. You have not only to believe it, but you have to get up and do something about what you believe. And this is what we, amen, as the church are. We're hearing what God's Word says, but we're not getting up doing anything about what we believe God's Word said. If God's Word said it, amen, and it's in the airways, all you have to do is let it resonate in your heart, let it resonate out of your mouth, speak it out of your mouth, amen. Speak that is not as though it were, amen, and it will line up with what's already in the atmosphere, and it will come to pass in your life. That's how you strengthen yourself. So you that are sick, all you got to really do is say, I am healed. According to the Word of God. With His stripes, I'm already healed. With His stripes, I'm already healed. With His stripes, I'm healed. With His stripes. When you get up in the morning, say, with His stripes, I am healed. With His stripes, I am healed. I am healed in Jesus' name according to the Word of God. With His stripes. Put some words in the atmosphere. Amen. I have a job. Amen. I do have a job. God won't bless me with a job. I thank You for my job. Just start thanking God. God, I thank You for my job. Thank You for my job, God. Lord God, I don't know where it is yet, but I believe You're going to show it to me. I believe that You're going to make a way. I believe it right now. Hallelujah. Thank You for my job. Waiting's being made. Anybody need help? I'm waiting made. God, I thank You for, amen, releasing my benefits. I thank You for releasing the insurance. I thank You, Lord God, for doing it right. Insurance is expensive. Thank You, Lord God, for letting those people, amen, finally fill out the papers to release my insurance. You got to speak it out of your mouth. This is how you strengthen yourself. I'm almost done. Amen. The spirit of recognition. The spirit of recognition. Say that with me. The spirit of recognition.
Recognition.
It's in the atmosphere.
It's in the atmosphere.
All we have to do is tune into it. That's all we have to do. That's all we have to do. Go back. She used to fly all the time. I don't know if she ever went anywhere on business. But the thing about it is when your boss tell you to go to the airport to pick up Mr. Moore. You ain't seen Mr. Moore. The only thing you know about him is his name, Mr. Moore. Amen? You know that he is an important person. You know that he's coming, amen, to your company to get with your boss and the CEOs, amen, to make some adjustments concerning your company's future. It has been placed in your hands to make sure that you go to the airport and pick up Mr. Moore. That's all they told you to do. They didn't tell you how he was going to be dressed. They didn't tell you how he was going to smell. They didn't tell you how he was going to look. They didn't tell you how he was going to act. They didn't tell you if he was tall, Mr. Morris starts walking down the tarmac. That's all he's doing right there. That's all he's doing. Minding your own business. Are you Mr. Moore?
Yes, sir.
How you doing, Mr. Moore? I'm Mr. Steele. I'm supposed to take you to my company and present you to my CEOs. It's good to meet you, sir. May I take you back?
Amen.
Take Mr. Moore back. Thank you, sir. You take him to the car. You take him to the hotel. The next morning, you take him to the job. Amen. Did y'all catch that?
Amen.
Did y'all really, really catch?
Yes.
The spirit of recognition is the spirit of cognition in the beginning. The spirit of cognition, amen, comes to play when you go down and read what God's word says. When you read what his word says about you, then you go down on your knees and you pray concerning God's word. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Concerning God's word, you don't know where his word is going to be manifested. You don't know where it's going to take place. You don't know what it's going to look like. Amen. The only thing that you're doing, amen, is praying and seeking God for what his word says. And next thing you know, you're riding down the highway. And the spirit of recognition hits you in the back of the head. Can you look to your right and say, when tomorrow, about this time, pull in there. Because that's the next place you're going to be.
Medicine that don't even,
amen.
Ain't even got nothing to do with their sickness.
Amen.
It's all in their head.
Amen.
And the doctors know. And they just get more money out of you.
Yeah.
The spirit of recognition will show, amen, a man that's seeking a wife. He that seeketh the wife, seeketh the good thing. So when he reads what God's word said, pray about it. And while he's having service in church one day, he happened to look over and see her. And there she is. I know what I wanted in my back of my mind, and now I'm looking at her. Or I'm looking at him. The spirit of recognition, it will cause you to recognize, amen, out of the spirit realm into the physical realm, the next place, the next appointment of your life, the next step you're supposed to take, the next turn you're supposed to make. It will cause you to recognize, amen, the place you're supposed to be next week, next month, next year. You don't know, amen, the power of God's word until it begins to take place in your life. And when it takes place in your life, people will look at you and see that there's something different about you, that there is a change. You don't look the same. You don't act the same. God is going to let, amen, amen, his spirit show up in your life.
Thank you, Lord.
In the power of his might. Let him do it. Step back. Let him do it. Let him do it. The only thing we need to do is strengthen ourselves so that when he do it, we'll be able to step into it.
Jesus.
By faith. Amen.
Amen.
Evangelist Moore, you're strengthening yourself right now and taking classes. Amen. If someone was to offer you a $65,000 in the nursing, right?
Healthcare.
If someone was to offer you a job making $65,000 in the healthcare field, amen, you wouldn't be able to step into it because you don't have the knowledge.
But when you go through your schooling, they're giving you the knowledge. They're giving you credentials at the end. When they offer you the job, you won't have no problem.
I don't know if I can take the job. What's your name? What's your first name, man?
It's not Sylvester, but my Christian middle name is Timothy.
Tim, I don't know if they offered me a $65,000 job, Tim. I don't know if I can do it or not.
Amen. You won't be saying that to Tim. They offered me a $65,000 job. I'm starting tomorrow, and ain't nothing going to hold me back from it.
Hallelujah. Probably because I strengthened myself. God opened the door, and I stepped right through.
Amen.
I think Pastor Steele was going to do it earlier.
Amen. This is what the Spirit of God is talking about.
He's going to open doors. But if we don't strengthen ourselves, if we don't make ourselves ready, if we don't make ourselves available, how in the world are we going to step through it?
Amen.
Romans 10, 9 and 10. Somebody get Romans 10, 9 and 10. 10, 9 and 10. You got to increase in your faith. You have to increase in your faith. You have to increase in your faith. Somebody read that when you get it, please. Romans 10, 9 and 10. Read it.
That if thou wilt confess with thy mouth, the Lord Jesus,
yes,
thou shalt believe in thine heart,
yes,
that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
Thou shalt be saved. If you believe it in your heart, confess it with your mouth, amen, thou shalt. Read on a little bit more.
For with the heart man believes unto righteousness,
And
with the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
So believing is not just enough. You have to confess it out of your mouth.
Yes.
When you believe and you confess it out of your mouth, then God said you shall be saved. And you have to step out on what God's word said, regardless of what your past say. Your past will tell you you're not good enough. Your past will tell you you're going to have to, amen, go to church a couple more years before you get saved. Your past will tell you I'm not old enough. God can save young people just as well as he can save older people.
And
if your faith level is up to what God's word says and you step out on it, God will save you. It's by faith. Now what you need to do is continue to walk in the things of God. Fasting, praying, and reading his word. Knowing what God's word says. Because he told the 70 to go to Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. Amen. Come here, Shay.
Being endued with power from on high simply means God is taking off his justification, his righteousness,
Jesus,
and he's draping it around your shoulders.
Thank you, Lord.
That's all it is, right? Being endued with power, God said, I'll give you my power, I'll put it upon you. Amen. And you have to have the faith that power is upon you.
Amen.
Upon you to do what? To cause you to walk in the righteousness of God, in the justification of God. You that have been saved and put on by confessing, you can say, I am
the righteousness
of God.
I am
justified by God.
I am
a son,
a daughter,
a child
of God.
But as surely as we can put on the righteousness of God, we can take it off. Hallelujah. The Bible says, no man shall be able to pluck you out of my hand. That's what the word of God said. So if I give my heart to him by faith, trusting in him, and begin to walk in his righteousness until he baptized me in the Spirit, amen, no man will be able to pluck me out of his hand. No man, no woman, no man, I don't care what you did, nobody can pluck you out of his hand except one person. Can anybody tell me who that one person is?
Yourself.
You are the only one, take it on. You're the only one that can take the righteousness of God off.
Jesus.
And when you take it off, where is it going to go? Right back to him. It's going to go right back to him.
Mm-hmm.
We are the only ones that can reject God.
Mm-hmm.
So when he calls for us to strengthen ourselves, when he calls for us amen, to be endued with the power of God. It's as simple, amen, as putting on his righteousness by faith. I put it on. I got it on. I don't care what you say about me. Amen. I'm walking in it. Now I have power, strength, dunamis, power, authority, ability. For what? To overcome anything that the devil puts in my way. He says when I put on his righteousness, he gives me salvation. Deliverance from what? Deliverance from sickness. Deliverance from the enemy, the devil. Deliverance, amen, from every habit in my life in the past. God can deliver me, amen, and bring me through, even through the valleys where I'm going to walk. He said, when I send you out, no scorpion, no snake, and the physical will be able to, if they do bite you, because you may get bit. I can't get no help in here. You might get bit.
Amen.
He told the 70 disciples that he sent out, when I send you out, go without money, go without purse, go. No matter where you go, go. Snakes bite you. They ain't gonna kill you. Scorpions sting you. They ain't gonna kill you. There are gonna be people that's gonna try to poison you. But if you drink any deadly thing, it ain't gonna hurt you.
Yes, thank you.
That's in the physical. Now let's step up in the spiritual, because that same commission God told us to go out, amen, is still out there. But there are still snakes, scorpions, and poisonous things in the spirit realm. And the devil is trying to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yes.